Let's go, move.
Good, don't bow out, Chambers.
You're how many pounds? 3,412.
Let's go, put it up.
Needless to say, this was a little easier for me than for Jason.
Shh, nine, come on, push. Up. Come on, Jason. Up, push. Come on, Jason. Push him up. Push.
Nice.
What do you think of that exercise?
It's like bench pressing a pickup.
Then we had a 5-mile run across the rocky terrain around the castle's perimeter.
Let's go, pick it up.
It was a hell of a warm-up. But Aris reminded us that endurance was key to becoming a true Greek athlete.
There's something that in the Greek world we call the inner pneuma. And that is when you gotta reach deep down inside and you gotta be able to bring that innermost deep energy that you've got out. So you gotta be able to work while you're exhausted. It's when you're exhausted that you can determine whether or not you're a good fighter.
And so the training continued. To perfect our coordination and strengthen our punches, we hurled 15-pound stones, deadlifted 200-pound urns, shin-kicked and elbowed logs wrapped in twine.
17, 18, 19, 20.
And pounded sacks of sand, pushing our bodies to the limit to prepare ourselves for the punishment of full contact pancration.
Nice and smooth, very good.
I'm more sore today than I have ever been working out at the gym. I'm sore in places I didn't know I could be sore.
Finally, as evening set in, Aris invited us back inside the castle to mend our aching bodies by the fire and enjoy a traditional pancration dinner.
This is exactly what they used to eat. High protein, high fiber, low carbs, and even the type of carbs that they had was very natural. And because it was all stone milled back then, it provided a lot of energy.
So these guys really knew how to eat for fighting.
Yes, they did.
It was amazing to think that nearly 3,000 years ago, the ancient Greeks knew just as much as we did about what to eat to strengthen and repair the body. The protein in the meal would help rebuild the microscopic tears we'd put in our muscles during the day's training. And the balance of fiber and carbohydrates would give us energy for our next day. And we'd need it.
The next morning, Bill and I woke up early to spar like the ancients. Aris taught us that the key to winning an ancient pancration fight wasn't any single move. It was the combinations. Learning to transition effortlessly from standing strikes to throws to grappling, and ultimately to a choke that could end the fight or your opponent's life.
Here's my first window of opportunity. Here's my second window of opportunity. This is where I come in this way.
Carry in, that's it, really good. Turn them over right away, turn them over. Come on, that's it, right up, go for them. Up, one, two, that's it, all the way around. Take and flip off this way.
I have a hard time once I get a hold of the neck letting it go.
That's a good thing, man. That's a good thing. Pancratius were headhunters to begin with. Right down, wrap your arms right around. There you go. So you're pulling him backwards, you're cranking him up. Slip jabbing right under. Tug his face to the...
After the sparring, it was back to the mountaintop trails for more Spartan-style conditioning, but with a twist.
Let's go. Move.
Now, we had to run with a man on our backs, learning to keep our balance, even with the additional weight. After the run, it was back to our old school condition. And then, as the sun went down, it was time for another round of sparring.
Slip into that shit. Now pull his head, that's it. Use your wrist to pull him back.
I didn't know there were so many ways to work out not having modern equipment. These are unique ways to train for a fight.
14.
And I feel trained.
15.
And I'm coming for this guy.
There was so much left to learn of this ancient fighting art. But training was over. Now it was time for our final challenge.
The fight would be held at the Zapion in the heart of Athens. It was in this actual building in 1896 that the Olympic Games started up again after a hiatus of 2,000 years. Inside, we met with Laz and his fighter, Konstantinos Skepernakos.
See you again?
Good to see you too.
Yes.
Hey, welcome once again. Welcome once again. How are you?
Hello.
Yeah, he's one of, of our world champions, and he was actually serving in special forces in Greece.
So this is the guy that you have for us to fight?
What do you think?
What we thought was Konstantino looks big and fast. With almost three millennia of combat heritage behind him, he had the confidence of a true fighter and a true champion. Going toe-to-toe with him was definitely going to be quite a challenge. To decide which one of us would fight, we took a cue from the ancients and let the gods decide.
Now, let's do it the customary way as they did in ancient Greece.
Aris told us that in the ancient Olympics, fighters were selected by drawing lots from an urn. Each fighter's initials were inscribed on a lot. The athletes whose lot was pulled would fight.
These don't all say Bill, do they? Okay. There's D's and J's. All right, ready? It's a J.
That's a B.
See, but in Greek, B actually stands for J.
Okay, anyway. That's fair. That's the way we're going to do it.
All right, you know what? I concede.
My uniform.
Here's your robe.
Thank you.
I'm in your corner.
All right.
Getting loosened up, I kept my mind on the techniques we'd practiced, thinking through how to use them.
Moving, our hands are up, Our elbows are in. Yes. Good.
Tell you what, feels great warming up for this fight. Felt great going all around Greece and learning this stuff. I'm hot, I'm ready. Got Jason in my corner, he's gonna be there for me. You ready, brother?
Let's do it, Bill.
Let's go.
The fight would have three rounds of 2 minutes each. There would be no hand strikes to the head or groin, but kicks to the head and knees to the body were allowed. A knockout, submission, or broken limb would automatically end the match. But it would also be scored by a referee. Points would be awarded for strikes, throws, and pins. And they would be deducted for illegal moves. Punches and elbows to the face and slams from a pin position.
Remember, he's going to be moving around a lot, so look for that kick to get it out of the way, get an angle, and take him down, okay? And then just breathe, all right, baby? All right.
My strategy for the first round was simple. Look for opportunities to use what I learned and stay loose and get a feel for my opponent. What I got was a good feel of his foot inside my head.
Get in there, Bill.
3 points for Konstantino. It was obvious he planned to stay on his feet and rack up points with strikes.
Now, use that.
I wanted to use my Spartan ground techniques.
Get on top. Nice.
I got 2 points for the takedown and another two for
Keep
the
working,
pin.
Bill.
Bill, work your left knee on his belly. Get your left knee on his belly. There you go.
Knee on his belly. I want you to work for mount. There you go. Now go over the mount. Go over the mount. Go over the mount. Mount. Nice. Stay on his back.
Bill, circle outside of his lead leg. Now you circle left. Whatever leg he's got in front, circle the other way.
I charged him, but Konstantino caught me with a sneaky sacrifice throw. Hitting a 3-ton stone column is not the best way to break your fall. 3 points for him. With another reset, it was right back to the ground. Konstantino was slippery. It was all I could do to keep him pinned to the mat.
Work to mount, mount. You can hit him, Bill. You can hit his back. You can hit just not to the spine. Use your body to turn his head back in. There you go. Keep doing that. Keep cranking. There you go. Keep walking. I'm walking back. Good. Walking back. A little more, Bill. A little more. One more. One more for me. One more.
And the first round was over. My throws and wrestling moves were giving me the edge, but I had to watch strikes.
And keep your hands up, because he had a point for that kick.
Yeah, I know. You only kicked me right in the face.
Because that was 3 points. I think you have 6-3. I could be wrong, but you're definitely up on points.
I had to be careful of penalties. I'd learn a lot of pancration moves, but not a lot of rules.
Keep it tight.
All right, right now. So we're to the...